Hey there, what's up everybody, Indru here, and today I'll show you how you can easily turn a day photo into night in Photoshop. So here we are in Photoshop and I have this beautiful picture. I downloaded this one from pexels.com. You can find the link to the images used in the description sections. Well, there are lots of different ways to turn a day photo into a night one, and you must have come across the very easy and the simple one, and that is by using a LUT or a color lookup table. You can simply go to the new adjustment icon and select color lookup, and from over here make sure 3D LUT file is selected, and you can choose one from the already provided Photoshop LUT files, and you can select moonlight or night from day. This does a really good job by transforming your photo and applying a nighttime color cast on it. And obviously you can add curves adjustments or any other adjustments that you like to boost up the colors or turn it more night-like. But here is one catch. This default LUT preset does not work well with every other photo. Like I have this one. So over here, if we try to add the same LUT file, let me select color lookup and let me change it to night from day. It does add a color cast, but it does not look that good, right? So you can also try the other LUT file that you can use to turn day to night, but again, it does not look that good. So we'll try our custom variations, and that too by adding simply two adjustment layers. So I'll just delete both of these layers. And let's get started with adding our custom adjustment layers. So we'll first add a blue photo filter to add that blue hue on our overall composition. So let's go to the new adjustment layer icon and select photo filter. From here, make sure preserve luminosity checkbox is not checked, because if it is checked, we won't get the desired effect. Let me show you. So we'll select this color picker and we'll take a shade of blue. Maybe this one, a dark and not that much saturated. I'll select OK and then drag the density all the way to 100%. It does add that blue color cast, but this is not the nighttime look at all, right? So we need to uncheck this preserve luminosity checkbox, and you can see it instantly adds that dark blue nighttime effect. So what this checkbox does, it preserves luminosity, and luminosity means the brightness or the luminous intensity of each and every pixel, right? So with this checkbox on, this photo filter adjustment layers will preserve the brightness of the individual pixels, but we do not want that. At nighttime, we do not want to preserve the brightness, so we'll turn it simply off. And this is our first adjustment layer. You can definitely go over here and tweak the blues to match the look that you are trying to apply over here. Let me keep it like this. I'll hit OK. And now one basic concept of colors for the nighttime effect. Every colors don't look as it is in nighttime, right? Every color looks unsaturated and everything looks kind of bluish. So we'll try to preserve the blues and take down the saturation of each and every color. So we'll just add a hue saturation layer, but this is very important. Make sure your new hue saturation layer is below the photo filter layer. If your hue saturation layer is above the photo filter layer, the effect will not work correctly. So make sure your hue saturation layer is in between the photo filter and your main image. So double click to open your hue saturation layer, and over here you can simply open this drop down menu to control the color saturation of the different channels. So we'll go to the reds and simply take down the saturation to around -50. You do not have to be perfect, but you can simply try and vary this based on your image, but something around -50 works. Now let's take down yellows. Again, we'll go to somewhere around -50. Let's take down the greens to -60 is fine. We will not be changing the cyans and the blues because those are the colors that we want to preserve, right? So we'll keep the cyans as it is, and we'll also keep the blues as it is, and we'll again go to magentas and we'll take the saturation down all the way to around -50. Done. That's it. So we have our nighttime effect applied on top of our image with two simple adjustment layers. So this is before and this is after. So you can definitely add some other adjustment layers like curves to boost things up a bit if you want, and you can get all fancy with this, but yes, these are the two layers that you'd need to turn your day photo into a night one. So now let's apply these two adjustment layers onto our second example. I'll simply delete this color lookup table and I'll go to our first example. I'll hold shift and select these two adjustment layers and simply drag them and drop them onto this image. And you can see that it does really give that nighttime feel. You can again go over here and go to the individual channels if you want to take down the saturation of different colors. You can change the color intensity to something bright blue maybe. And definitely you can add other adjustment layers to brighten or make things pop. Just like that. Now let's go back to our first example and I'll show you one cool trick over here. I'll simply select both of these layers by holding shift on the keyboard and I will hit Ctrl G or Command G on the keyboard to group them and we'll maybe rename it as night. Now what I'll do is to add real nighttime effect, we'll make some light source glow and we'll create that light reflection on different areas to give you the overall idea on how you can spice things up and give that final touch. So we'll just select the background image and we'll hit Ctrl J or Command G on keyboard to duplicate it. We'll take it up all the way to the very top above the night filter or the night group that we created just now. Make sure your image copy is selected. We'll add another photo filter. So let's go to the adjustment layer and select photo filter. And we'll add one orange color cast. Make sure preserve luminosity is not checked and increase the density all the way to 100%. Let's click our color and we'll maybe select an orangish yellow color to imitate the color of bulbs or gas lamps and let's click OK. We'll also add a little curves adjustments to make this layer pop. Great. With that done, I'll hold shift on the keyboard and select our copy of the main image so that all the three new layers get selected and I'll hit Ctrl G or Command G on the keyboard to group them and maybe we'll rename the group to light. Now make sure you are holding Alt on the keyboard or Options on the keyboard if you're on Mac and click this layer mask icon to add an inverted layer mask. So the layer mask is added with the color black filled in, so everything is now hidden. So now if you take a brush and maybe something like soft round and with reduced opacity and fill, and if you have a pen tablet, so it'll be really accurate and precise to do things over here. But if you are on mouse, that's also fine. Simply reduce the opacity and reduce the flow. And then make sure color white is selected and start painting on the layer mask. Because as you know, if you paint with white on layer mask, it reveals. And if you paint with black, it conceals or it hides, right? So we had one light over here. So this is a light bulb and here is also a lamp. And I think here is also a light. So make sure you are selecting the layer mask and with the color white selected, we'll simply try to paint and you can see that we are trying to recreate the light source. We'll zoom in a bit. We should have light reflection on this area also. So I'm doing it very fast and you can take as much time as you want to perfect things up. I'm using the square bracket keys on the keyboard to control the size of my brush. You can press X on the keyboard to invert the colors and if black is selected and if you paint on the layer mask, it will hide what you have done. Here we have a lamp hanging over there. So let's zoom in and let's fill the block. I'm selecting with the lasso tool. And let's fill it with white. Let's deselect the selection and we would be having some glow on this wall. So let's do that. And let's do something different over here. We had sunlight coming around this region. You can see there is an area which is lit. So let's try to make this one yellow with our current light glow layer. and we'll create an impression that the light source is maybe coming from this side. So we'll try to create that impression. Let's clear up some areas where the light should not be and where there should be shadow. And now let's make some light coming through the windows. Let's zoom in. I'll select the polygonal lasso tool and quickly mark the windows and fill it in. Let's deselect the selection and let's make some areas glow with this light source. Can see there are some light bleed over here. Let's make light coming out from this window also, and maybe this window. Let's deselect the selection, and we have one light bulb over here, so let's make it glow. So I think you get the basic idea of what I'm trying to do over here. So you can take as much time as you want to perfect things and get that perfect look. I think here should be some light highlights over here. Not too much, just a tad bit. Yep. And just for the sake of this composition to look good, we'll just add one final touch to make those light bulbs glow. We'll simply add a new layer and change its blending mode to hard light, and then select a pale yellow color from here, and we'll just dab once or twice just on the bulb to give an impression that it's glowing. Let's do the same for this distant lamp and also this light bulb. Maybe we'll reduce the opacity a bit. Okay, so this is how you can very easily change your day photo to a night one with simply two adjustment layers, that is a photo filter to add that blue color cast and a hue saturation layer to take down all other color saturation except the blues. And to spice things up, you can simply make a copy of your main image and add a orange yellow color cast and a curves adjustment to replicate the glow of the light bulbs, and paint on the layer mask just to show those lit up areas. So this is the before and this is the after. I hope you like this video. Do like the video and subscribe my channel so that you do not miss out any tip, tricks or photo manipulation that I do next. I'll see you in the next one, and till then, stay creative.